Hi everyone, I'm Lim. Today I'm going to review a reball kit. It is very helpful to those beginners who are struggling to reball the BGA IC, especially the CPU. You know, those BGA IC that with hundreds or maybe thousands of balls, they are more difficult to the beginners because they don't know how to hold the sensor. They don't know how to fill the hole properly. And even the temperature they apply to, or maybe the airflow is wrong. So not only they cause pot up, most of the time they have uneven balls, big and small. I think you know what I'm saying. So before I review the tool, I'm going to show you how I usually teach my students. Okay, I'm going to reball this CPU. As you can see, I will put the tissue below the IC. It is because the tissue can protect from the cold. It doesn't matter what country you're from. Below the IC, so cold. Even they are not cold, they are warm. They will absorb the heat away. They will take away the heat. It will cause you have a longer duration to heat up the IC. It will cause you a longer duration to get the ball melted. Some IC, they are heat sensitive. Even the CPU, it has the limit to suffer. Overheated can cause a shock. It can kill the IC. Okay. This is why we put the tissue on here, protect from the cold. And then even the heat can be so focused. Also, the tissue can help me to check the other things. They are the reference point. If I see the burn mark, they are so dark, it means my heat is overkill. But I don't need to share those details because they are in my online course. This is YouTube, so I'm going to teach you in a faster way. There are many reball techniques. I'm going to show you one of it. Most of the beginner that suffer reball is because they don't know how to fill the solder paste properly. So let's begin. And this should be the iPhone 5 CPU. I'm going to put on the stencil. Okay. So the problem of the beginner is because when they fill it, they haven't hold it down. If you have a gap like this, see, space, if you feel it first time, okay, it is fine, but they keep feeling second time, third time. Before your second time feeling, this sensor is popping up. The second run will keep adding more paste between the gap. It is because you didn't hold it properly. This is one of the tips. If you have a sensor like this, my sensor is not so perfect. The meter, they are a little spacey. You can also feel part by part. I can feel this part first and then come to here, I feel again. Okay, you do not go over, do not repeat the area that already filled. Then you will have an even balls. Okay, that's a tip number two. So let's begin. Also, you need to make sure you have a clean sensor. Okay. I'm going to adjust under the camera so then you can see the whole process. Okay, this angle will be good. So let's see how I reball. First, you're going to get a good solder paste, not too wet and not too dry. So get as many as possible because you are going to try to refill them in one shot. I will begin from top half by holding with my finger like this way. Okay, so you see top half is done and I going back to take away, not to filling. So if I let go slowly, they will pop up. You will see some dark hole. Do not fill them because they are enough. And then what you're gonna do is hold the other half, okay? Make it tight. And then you can go repeat because they are tight, they have no space below. The place you don't repeat is the place that is popping up. Okay, so meter, I still need a little. So that's how to reball. Now I'm taking off those I'm not feeling. So those dark holes do not fill again, and use a cloth to wipe them. Right, it is absolutely normal. They look like this way. And how you hold the stencil, also one of the key. Okay, I will hold it like this way, this side as tight as possible, and leave the other side. You don't need to hold entire IC, because I will begin heating from here and then slowly go up. So by the time I go going up, I will let go of the beginning area and then slowly going to the right side. Okay, so let's begin. I'm not going to share my temperature, because different solder paste and even different machine, different airflow, different setting. Even I share it, your machine is not calibrated. You cannot just copy my temperature. Unless you are my students, you know how to tune the machine. So now I'm just warming up, because the whole stencil is so cold and my machine is just started. I will begin from the left corner below, okay, like this way, and slowly, you see the balls slowly. We don't want too fast, okay, going left, right, like that. Okay, it's done. You might see some balls that are not handling, okay, such as this dot here. Okay, let me show you under the camera. You see, he missed. He didn't enter. You can inject some flux below. Okay? Just put some flux on top and then come back. Point at him. Okay? He gets in. And then the lower corner here, we miss. So we point at them. Okay. By having a good flux is important, because a good flux can do the things like this. Okay. He can help to get installed. So this is how we reboil properly. Okay, pop it up. There we are. And hold the IC. Reflow it. Why we need to reflow is because we need to make sure none of the balls that are not installed, they are running around. Okay. This is how the traditional way of reball. Okay. A reball have many techniques. This is just one of it, the traditional method. So back to the topic, as I told you, I'm going to review this reball kit. Every time when you heard the reball kit, it is related to the magnetic. Okay, this is my old magnetic, but actually the new thing is this one, the thermal pad. They are designed for reball. Not only he can do the same job, like my tissue here, it actually is helping you to reball like this way. Let me show you, then you can understand. First, you put on top of the magnet here. Okay, put the same IC here. I already have cleaned the IC. And then, just position your stencil. That simple. You can do it single hand without the tweezer to hold it. Okay. So you see, if I place it, there's not so much space between. You can feel as much as possible. You know, to have a stronger magnet, you can get more than triple. Just remember, the thermal pack doesn't come with the magnetic you're gonna buy separately. They have a few options. You can choose the one with a bigger magnet to have a maximum effect. So just because I only have a triple magnet, it's not too strong, so I will resander after a position. Okay, I will check where is my center point and I will drag down a little. Okay. Oh, that will be enough. Okay, see. Four corners, they're tight. So then you will not have a beginner mistake. Because beginner mistake, why they have uneven balls, I already told you just now. Because they keep filling. And the gap, because there's a space below. Once they take off the sensor, they will see a mess. But you have a magnet like this, you don't need to worry about that. So I will just feel like a beginner. You don't need to hold a sensor with the tweezer anymore. Then clean it. Okay, so same technique, but I don't need to hold the tweezer. I will begin from the lower left. Warm up a little. Okay, going left, right, fast, like that way. Let's see everyone, they're melted. Okay, it is done. So I still need the tweezer to pop it out. Let's see how's the effect. Let's see how's the result, okay? So far so good, reflow. Okay, so here's the result. See that? I think I missed a ball. Yes, I have missed a ball. We still can fill it back like that way. Okay, now I teach you how to hold the IC while you're flowing. I will lay another tweezer on top, just like this way. And then another hand. As I told you, if you don't have a tissue below, it will take longer time to melt the ball. Okay, this is a bad example. You flow in this way, you are killing the IC. But doesn't matter. You see, it takes so long to get melted. It is the same temperature, I haven't changed it. It takes that long. So without a tissue below, it will be like this. It is not good. But anyway, this is just a demonstration. this IC actually is not useful anymore. I just use it to demonstrate how the reball is done. So that's why I can take the risk like that way. It is coincidence that I'm wearing the same color as this thermal pack here. Do not think I'm hard selling this because I get the commission. I don't. In case you haven't noticed, it doesn't have any link below my description, so I don't get commission at all. I just want to share some good stuff, especially for the beginners who are new into this field. You know, even some old students that are from other academies, they do struggle the reball. I have seen a lot. Okay, it is not a surprise to me because even for myself, like 10 years ago when I was just started to learn how to reball the BGA, okay, how to do the CPU, I remember I really have struggled about like few days because that time those training center that don't have a microscope with the camera, even for that half, they cannot teach like the way I did just now. They are not that detailed. But anyway, by having the camera with your microscope, I believe the teacher can notice what is your mistake. By the way, if you're still having reball problem with a traditional method, even though you have followed my way, I believe the reason is either your temperature, your airflow setting, your machine is different, your solder paste problem, it could be the stencil problem as well. Do not underestimate these kind of things. This is why practical skill is best you train in the center. I do have an offline class that's running. If you're interested, you can take a look in my website. But my one won't be cheap because I am constantly watching you. It's kind of like training one-on-one. I will correct your mistake. It's not like I teach you one thing and I leave you to there for like few days or maybe few hours to let you figure yourself. It's different. That kind of training style is 10 years ago. It shouldn't happen in now. So anyway, reball skill, the traditional method without magnetic, is a must-have skill. So this tool here is really useful for all kind of stencil. You just put on top. Any type of stencil, you just lay on top. It will suck it. So I guess that's it for the video, and I see you in the next video. Bye.